let's discuss and explain the to-do list part. So as we can see here in the application, this is our to-do list page, and we have different categories, and inside each category we can see the list of to-dos. So let's go back here now. So in this component, the to-do list, in the to-do list component.html, we have this block of div. For example, when we subscribe a new user and the user has no categories or no to-dos, we will just display this message, no to-dos found, and please create a new category to start. Else, if we have categories for the users, we will use this accordion. So this is this component from Angular Material Design. And inside that, we will use an expansion panel. Once we expand this one, we will display the content inside. So, and inside this expansion panel, we have the expansion header. We have the expansion header, and then we have the body, or we can display whatever we want inside that. So the panel header here, we have the title, which is the category name, and we will loop over the categories. We'll display the category name, and for the description, we will display the description. And then for the label at the end, for the label, sorry, at the end, we will display the length of the to-do list. And here, as I explained before, the exclamation, the interrogation mark is, for example, when the to-do list is null or undefined, we will not raise an exception. So we display this length only if we have a to-do list, not empty. So this is what we just see together. This is the title, the description, and this is the length. Next, we will loop over the to-do list of each category. So first of all, we will loop over the categories, and then we will loop over the to-do list of each category. So for each to-do list, we will display the to-do element, which is this one. So this is a to-do element, and then what this to-do element takes as parameters or input, we have the to-do DTO and the category. So here we have the to-do DTO, so we can display or do whatever we want with this DTO, and without a need to query the database or to query the backend for the to-do. So for example, here we can pass just the to-do ID, and then we do a query and get the to-do from the database or from the backend side. But it's gonna be a waste of resources and waste of performances. So it's better we have the object, we just pass the object as a parameter, and then we do whatever we want with it. And the category here, the category might be needed later. So that's why we have it as a parameter. Now let's check. So this is the HTML part. Let's check now how we get the categories and the to-dos and so on and so forth. So we have the to-do list. Here for the to-do list, I use my services, which is category service and activated rooted and user service. So here I have a method in the on init method. I have another method which is called resolve time parameters, because the same component to-do list is used for whether the to-do list URL or the to-do list slash today, if I want, for example, and display my day information or my day to-do. So here, if here I will try to get the parameter from the activated root, which is this dot activated root, this parameter I already, this type or this parameter I already injected in the constructor. I get the snapshot with, and then the parameters, which are the URL parameters. For example, here when I say, I don't know, slash one slash hello slash I don't know what, and then we can get all those parameters. So this parameter, just to avoid all kind of confusions, it's defined. I will explain it quickly because I will explain the routing later. So to make it clear, Yeah. So here we have this URL. It's the to-do list slash display slash the parameter name is called start. So when I say here params.start, it will automatically be mapped with this parameter name. So it's not something like default or something owned by Angular or something like that. So it's defined by us. And then I check if the parameter equals today. For example, if I want the list of today's list, what I will do, I will query the backend using the dedicated method. For example, here, get all for today. Else, if not, if I don't have this parameter, for example, in our case, I have only the to-do list. So then I will call this method init categories. And this method init categories, I will just call my category service and get all by user. So I only need to get the categories for the connected user and not all the categories for all the users. And then I just assign the data to the categories, and the HTML will do its part and display everything. Now let's go and check this element or this component, the to-do element. This is quite easy also. We have the to-do element, and as we can see here, we have the title, we have the date here, the description, and we have two those icons, and we have the update button. So here, when I get my to-do, and I will also show it here, and as you can see, it's an input, the to-do DTO and the category DTO. Then I will display the title of the to-do as the card title. We have also the start date, description. And for those buttons, when I click here and I click done, so here the thing is that I use two buttons. The first one is with the favorite border, this one. That means this button without the color. And then when I click on it, I will call the method add to favorite. And if this to do is already a favorite one, it's going to be displayed. It's going to be displayed as red here, and the color is warning. So this is why it's displayed in a red color. And when I click on it again, I will remove it from favorite. And the same for the to-do. I have the check circle and I have the radio button unchecked. So this is the check circle and this is the radio button unchecked. So when I check it, it's gonna be done, and else it's gonna be undone. And then I have the edit button, this one. When I click on it, it's gonna take me automatically to the edit or to the create to-do component. And here it takes, I have only the click action. So here I will just also try to explain a few things here. The add to favorite, remove, set done, and set undone. Actually, this all methods is just to save the to-do, and every time we will change or update the dedicated field. For example, to add to favorite, so what we will do, this to-do DTO.favorite equals true, and then I will call the save method, which will save my to-do, and then if the operation is successful, I will update the to-do DTO. So this is all about the to-do list. So as we can see here, we are using so many components inside here. So we have the material components and also our custom components, which is the to-do list and the to-do element. So see you in the next part.